Most things that are worth doing once are worth doing twice. We're going to see how this applies to derivatives. So let's think about a function, like for example the function x squared that we studied before. And we've already studied the derivative of f of x. The derivative of f of x is the rate at which this function changes. And we compute that by taking two nearby points, x and x plus h, seeing how much the function has differed between them, dividing by h, and taking a limit as h goes to 0. And in the case of the function x squared, this was a pretty easy calculation. X plus h squared minus x squared gives you 2xh plus h squared, divided by h gives you 2x plus h, take the limit as h goes to 0, and we got 2x. So the derivative of x squared was 2x. And there are a lot of different notations for the derivative. We've been using the prime notation. We've been calling it f prime of x. Another common notation is to write df dx. And if you're looking at the curve y equals f of x, then you might call that dy dx, because in that case, y and f of x are the same thing. These are all notations for the same thing. Another one that comes up less often is d sub x of f. We'll mainly look at these three notations. And I'm going to use these three notations interchangeably from now on. Okay, so now we've got that f prime of x equals 2x. Yeah, but that's a function in its own right. So, if it's a function, we can take its derivative to understand how quickly it's changing. Now, the derivative of f prime of x, if we're using prime notation, is usually denoted f double prime of x. And it's the first derivative of f prime, or it's the second derivative of f, because you have to take a derivative of f twice to get from f to f prime to f double prime. Other notations are d squared f dx squared, d squared y dx squared, or d sub xx, or d squared sub xx of f. Again, this is less common. These two we're going to see a lot. But whatever you call it, it's the rate at which f prime is changing. And so you compare the value of f prime at nearby points, divide by h, take a limit. It's exactly the same as the definition of the derivative of f, except everywhere that you had an f before, now you've got an f prime. So in our case, f prime of x is 2x, f prime of x plus h is twice x plus h. The x's cancel, 2h over h is 2. Hooray! We can look at the third derivative. The third derivative of f is the derivative of f double prime. And here are some other notations for it. And it's the rate at which f double prime is changing. So in this case, how fast is f double prime changing? Well, f double prime of x plus h is 2, and f double prime of x is 2. It's not changing at all. F double prime happened to be a constant. Constants aren't changing at all, so the rate at which it's changing is 0. So in this instance, f triple prime was 0. It isn't always 0. Sometimes it's a more interesting function. But in this instance, we started with the function x squared, took its derivative, got 2x, took the derivative of that, got 2, took the derivative of 2, got 0. Okay. Now there's a particular instance where taking higher derivatives has real physical meaning, and that's where we have a position as a function of time. So if s of t is a position at time t, then the rate at which that position is changing, we usually call that velocity. That's the first derivative. The derivative of velocity is called acceleration. So acceleration is the second derivative of position. The derivative of acceleration is called jerk. That's the third derivative of position. The derivative of jerk is called snap. And after a while, you start saying, gee, I don't feel like drawing a whole bunch of primes, so instead of writing f's S prime 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 prime, you just put a 4 in parentheses to indicate that there are 4 primes there. So it's the rate of change of the jerk. The derivative of the snap is the crackle, and the derivative of the crackle is the pop. And yes, those are the real names. So later on, we are going to look at graphs, and we're going to see what the derivatives and the higher derivatives mean in terms of graphs. We've already seen that the first derivative of a function is the slope of a tangent line. Second derivative has something to do with curvature. It's a little bit harder to explain. Third derivative and higher, it's harder to explain. At this stage, I would say stick to the idea that each derivative is a rate of change. So the first derivative is the rate of change of the function. The second derivative is the rate of change of the first derivative. The third derivative is the rate of change of the second derivative, and so on.